Get ready to match the stars. Edward Asner, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Trish Stewart, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Ragger.
Now, let's say hello to these gifted and celebrated people. You are all gifted and celebrated.
That's true.
And that's all I have to say.
Oh, okay.
But I greet you, one and all, and ask you to join me in greeting Jerry Gay and Lyle Bliss. Jerry Lyle and Gay Bliss. Gay Lyle and Bliss Jerry. Listen, this is Jerry Gay. She's our current champ. She's got a pretty good bundle of money, $5,600. That's very good of you. That's an interesting pendant you're wearing. I've never seen that exactly, but it's. Can you see that?
I can.
You can? Well, it's an arrow pointing to the nether regions. That's as far as we can explore that. Now, Lyle, you did very well.
Yeah, but I didn't win any money.
You didn't win any money yet?
Well is when you make money.
Well, now, wait a minute. We went to the tiebreaker. You had your tiebreaker question. You matched 5 out of the 6 celebrities. So she's got a lot of hard
With
work
her,
to do.
Mm. 5 isn't enough. And it was interesting, though, you said Jerry Bliss. And that happens to be my brother's name.
No kidding.
Yeah, his hair is a little longer, and he's got bluer eyes, but he looks something like her.
We'll finish this tiebreaker. Right after we pass along these messages
to you.
Here we go. Tiebreaker. Now, Jerry Gay, this is yours. Whoops, there it is. Remember what you have to do. You got to match 5 to tie for the second tiebreaker, or 6 to win. Everybody plays.
Sure.
Karen said, "My husband is really mean." Rotten. You are a rotten bunch of performers there. No, my husband is really mean. He took all my padded bras and left me blank. My husband is really mean. He took all my padded bras and left me blank. My husband is really mean. All righty.
Ready?
Charles is ready.
I'm ready.
Very good.
Ready.
Okay. Edward is the slow one this trip. But remember, he's a big nighttime star on CBS's Mary Tyler Moore Show.
Terrific.
And he is terrific.
And he's cute and everything, and he's sexy.
I like him because he's versatile. You know, when he played in Rich Man, Poor Man, he did a very interesting thing there. Beautiful. Okay. Karen said, "My husband is really mean. He took all my padded bras and left me
flat."
Oh, she's too smart for this job.
She came up with the definitive answer. Now it's up to the celebrities.
How much more of the shame am I going to have to take?
Oh, what do you mean? Huh? You didn't do it again, huh?
I mean, the shame is almost as bad as your eulogy. I said the stuffing.
Took all my padded bras and left me the stuffing. Now you got to match all of the others, Jerry, and let's see what Brett has.
Oh, Jerry, I'm so sorry. That's a terrific answer. I said his jockey shorts.
His jockey shorts, so that means Lyle Bliss wins the game. What the rest of you got? Flat, 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 flat. All the others have flat. Come on down, Lyle. You remember how this goes? What's that?
She had the answer.
She had the answer, right. Well, listen, you can't win them all there. Don't turn your back to the audience. Right. They're out that way. You stand right here, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, Jerry Gay, you'll be leaving here with $5,600 and our best wishes. It was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you. I really enjoyed it.
I'm glad you did. Jerry Gay. Goodbye. Okay. Stand on the adhesive tape. All right. You can look out that way now. Okay. They're out that way. That's okay.
I see them out there.
You see them out there? Oh, good. Now, listen, Lyle, you can win over $5,000 here. You ready for that?
I'm ready, man.
All right, buddy, let's go. We polled the recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Everything blank. Now, the answer that group gave most frequently is worth $500, but you got to match it. If you match a middle one, you get $250. You match a bottom one, you get $100.
Wow.
Can't lose here, can you?
I got it.
Now, three of the ding-a-lings are permitted to help.
Trish.
How about everything is coming up roses?
Everything is coming up roses.
Everything coming up roses.
We don't want you to sing, Brett. When we want you to sing, we'll ask you, Brett, okay?
Okay, let me have it, Brett.
Everything goes.
That's it. That's your answer.
Everything goes, all right? You can call on one more.
Edward.
It's tough. I said for nothing.
No. What?
Wrong.
Everything for nothing.
Where's my
everything?
Everything for nothing. That's his answer. I don't know what it means, but there it is. Everything for nothing. Everything goes, and everything's coming up roses. Now, do you want one of those? A better idea might have crossed your mind. Think.
Nothing has crossed my mind in years. What did I say?
What do you want? Everything for nothing. Everything goes.
Everything goes. That's it.
Ah!
That it? That's it. Oh, you said that a little while ago. Yeah.
That's it.
I
made up my mind.
Okay, everything goes what he wants. That's the answer that Brett gave him. Here we go. We're going to find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Let's go down to the bottom. We will reveal the $100 response. Everything's coming up roses.
That's
Trish's answer. Yeah. Okay, we're looking for everything goes. Here's a $250 number. Everything is beautiful.
Everything I have is yours.
Everything but the kitchen sink, thank you.
It's anything goes.
Oh, you don't think it's going to come up? Anything goes.
If it does,
yeah.
It does.
And if it doesn't, it doesn't. You really are a true philosopher. You know that?
Everything goes on this one. Yeah. Tense up,
he says.
Got it.
Guy in the second row, it's past tense up.
Past tense up. But, yes.
You ask Lyle to get back on his mark. We can't.
Yeah, I'm on.
No, there's the adhesive tape.
I never forget a back, but that's ridiculous.
One foot on the mark. All right, last chance here for everything goes. May we see the $500 number? Oh, you got it! Congratulations! You got it!
I was waiting for everything to come up there.
Funny?
I'm so messed up. I'm so excited. I need a funnel to stick my finger in my ear. I cleaned that up, you wouldn't believe.
Yeah, that right. So listen, you picked up another $500 here. You got a total of $600, Lyle.
We're thinking, no one.
But you can play for 10 times the $500 now.
Oh, shucks, you say.
No.
You're
going to get $5,000 now. $5,000. Ding. That's it. Thank you. Okay. You're on your mark. That's right.
Get set.
Now, wait. No, wait. I'll tell you.
You
got to pick one person.
They all look so nice sitting up there.
They look real, don't they?
Yeah.
It's a wax museum.
I thought we was going to meet celebrities. I was waiting to meet Roy Acuff. And I I'll pick Richard.
Oh, you'll take Richard.
No, I don't want to get involved. Pick somebody else.
I remember Richard.
Go find Roy Acuff. Go find Roy Acuff.
Go find Roy Acuff,
You didn't come here to be insulted.
Richard? That's Richard. Yeah, you want Richard.
Oh, no, it was you I remember.
Yeah, that's right. You stand on the table there, face that way. Okay, you've got it. All set. Here we go. It's worth $5,000 now. Get your ESP going over to Richard. Mm-hmm. If you get your ESP going over to Roy Acuff, blank whistle, W-H-I-S-T-L-E, blank whistle. Okay, Lyle, Richard is finished. Now, we asked you to put something in that blank which you think will match his. Now, think and give us the answer that Richard already wrote on that card. Blank whistle.
Train.
Train whistle. Okay. Now, He says, train whistle will match you for $5,000. Richard,
well,
what do you say?
He was a gambling man, and he would have heard the sound of a police whistle.
The police whistle.
Yeah. Told
They're
you to choose.
Bobby's.
Didn't
They're
I tell
Bobby's,
you to
yes.
choose Roy?
Yes. Told, he told said you he told you to choose Roy Acuff. Anyway, Lyle, you've picked up $600, and you're going to meet another player and play another game, so all is not lost. In the meantime, we'll pass along these messages to you. We're ready. Are you ready? Well, let's welcome another player, and here is Kathy Whitehead. All right, Kathy.
Thank you,
applause, applause. Charles, a little applause for Kathy Whitehead, dummy.
Oh, just wake him up.
Oh, no, dear me. Kathy, we welcome you, in spite of the fact that Charles did not applaud your arrival here, and we ask you to tell you, us, whoever, about her.
Well, I'm married, and...
Yes, I hope so.
And my husband's a pharmacy student
yep.
at USC,
yep.
and I have a little two-year-old baby boy.
Okay. And he.
And another one on the way.
And another one on the way. You're due, what, in a couple of months?
Yeah.
Okay, good luck to Kathy Whitehead. Here is round one, and Kathy, you may have A or B.
B for baby.
B for baby, she says. All right, but not on this stage. Carol said. Carol said, my boyfriend, the Eskimo, is cheap. I'm going to tell you anyway. On my birthday, all he gave me was a snow blank.
A snow blank.
A snow blank.
Hey, I've got that one. Right here.
Carol said, my boyfriend, the Eskimo, is cheap. On my birthday, all he gave me was a snow blank. Good.
Right, that's it. Well, cut off behind you, Charles. Couldn't you get to it, dear?
All right. Very good, Ed.
Oh, thank you.
I like it. Now, Kathy, Carol said my boyfriend, the Eskimo, is cheap. On my birthday, all he gave me was a snow blank.
A snowball.
Snowball. Okay. She said snowball, Ed.
What can I say? The guy was in ill health.
A snowball.
Right.
Yes, Brett.
From here, she looks like she might have that baby a little sooner than you think.
All right.
Four.
That's two for Kathy. Now, Charles.
I mightn't have applauded for you, and you embarrassed me in front of the entire nation.
Yes, I did. I want you to pay attention from now on, Charles.
I'll try to give her the right end.
He's really crying. But once in a while, we have to step down on him. Trish, are you ready?
Yes, a snowball.
Snowball. Look at that girl. That's four for her already. Richard?
And Charles should have applauded.
Yes, he should have.
Should have applauded for two.
Yes, for two, that's right.
He should be weeping. Welcome to the ball.
Welcome to the ball. Now, don't... get your hopes too high here. Because you have one more person to call on.
Ah, I beg your pardon?
Not vanilla, no.
No, no, a snow job.
Snow job. See? Okay, so Lyle, you go to work here now. Ready? This is your first rounder. Steve said, my wife is really mean. You're getting better. When I fell asleep in the bathtub, she tossed in a blank. My wife is really mean. When I fell asleep in the bathtub, she tossed in a blank. Into the bathtub. She's mean. Yeah.
I get it. I wonder if it works.
Yes, it works. Okay. Indeed. Put it down there. Whatever. Mean.
Honey bun. Now that works. Isn't that works? Isn't
right.
That?
Yes,
sure.
Indeed.
Okay. What would I do without you, sweetheart?
Yeah, that's okay, sure.
Hello, darling. How's your show going?
Very well.
Family
Farm,
or whatever.
Family
it's
Feud,
called.
It's called.
Oh,
going
yes.
very well. All right, Charles, ready? Okay, I'll walk over here to Lyle and call on him. Ed, did you put one in the slot? There you go. Thank you. Steve said, my wife is really mean, Lyle. He said, when I fell asleep in the bathtub, she tossed in a blank.
Bucket of ice. Oh, that's mean enough.
A bucket of ice.
Bucket of ice.
Yes. Just between us girls, it's a rotten answer. But we'll see what happens over here. What'd you say?
I was thinking of a bucket of ice.
Yeah, I bet you were.
But I changed it to shark.
So I said shark. Oh, the shark tags. What do you say?
I figured she really wanted to get rid of the little blank. So she threw in a radio and electrocuted.
That'll do it every time. And you?
And you.
And you, sir. Captain.
Captain Carter, sir.
Captain Andy.
An electric wire or device.
An electric wire device, that'll do it, yep. That's really the definitive answer here. Now we're up to Trish Stewart. When I fell asleep in the bathtub, she tossed in a...
Well, she wanted to give him a little bit of a chance, so she put in a shark.
A shark. Okay, sharks and electrical devices so far.
You're on there.
A piranha. Oh.
Man-eating little fish.
That would hurt.
Very easy to handle, though.
Yeah.
Shark is so clumsy.
That's right.
I see you going in with it.
Yeah.
I suspect. Piranha, you put here.
Stick right in there.
How are you, dear?
Yeah. Ben, that's it.
Godfrey Daniel!
The leg's gone.
Oh, gone. Right, the whole thing is gone. Oh. Huh? All right, Patty.
That's good, Piranha, of course.
That's right. No, different story. Follow that act.
Huh? I wasn't listening. I said pet piranha.
A pet piranha. Right. Bucket of ice. All right. So we didn't get a bucket of ice for you. But, so there's the end of round one. Score is 5-0 in favor of the pregnant challenger. And we've got a commercial message here for you. Okay, we're ready to go on to round two. And there they are, A or B. Miss Kathy, honey.
I had good luck with B, so I'll take B again.
B. Huh? Now, you know, you're only playing to one person. Guess who?
Oh, my dear.
That's you. All right. Oh, you and Kathy have to get it on together here now. Sam said to Fred.
Oh, them again, yeah.
Sam said to Fred. He says, that's your blind date over there, uh-huh. See? The one with the blank under her nose. Got the idea? That's your blind date over there, the one with the blank under her nose. Easy. Kathy Whitehead, Sam said to Fred, that's your blind date over there, you see her? The one with the blank under her nose.
The wart under her nose.
Wart. She said the one with the wart under her nose. What do you say?
I said the one with the hair under her nose.
The one with the hair under her nose. Okay, now, Lyle, you know what you have to do? Match 5-6 Sally Ram, the fan dancer, has really gotten modern. Instead of dancing with a feathered fan, she dances with a blank. You're too young to remember Sally Ram, huh? Sally Ram, the fan dancer.
Silly Sally Ram.
The fan dancer has really gotten modern. Instead of dancing with a feathered fan, she dances with a blank.
She's really gotten modern.
Modern, right.
Modern is the operative word.
That's right.
Speed up is the operative word.
Speed up there.
Oh, all right. I'll do that, too.
Okay.
I just have to know the operative word.
That's very good.
If I don't know the operative word, then, you know, I run into a lot of trouble.
I'll just walk over here.
Run, dear. Well, don't you know?
Come on, Ed. Quickly.
Yeah.
All right. Ready, Ed?
Yeah.
Okay. Lyle Bliss. Sally Rand, you know who she was, the fan dancer.
No, well.
Has really gotten modern. Instead of dancing with a feathered fan, she dances with a...
An electric fan.
That's a good answer.
That's it.
All right, he came up with the definitive answer, Ed.
Boy, I started to write the wrong one.
Electric fan. There's one for Lyle Bliss. Brett. He said electric fan.
I went that one step too far. I said an air conditioner.
That's another good answer. That was a good one, too. Now you got to match all the others. Charles?
I said air conditioner, too.
So that means Kathy Whitehead wins the game, and he is electric air conditioner. Come on down, Kathy. Congratulations. Now, stand around over here. You can sit down if you want. Now, Lyle, we congratulate you for winning $600. Thank you for being our guest here on Match Game 76. Lyle Bliss, there he goes. Okay, so long, old bean. While he's spinning off, we'll spin these messages just for you.
You're a dandy bunch, and I thank you all for making an excellent contribution to these here proceedings. Now, next time we get together, These are the celebrities who will be appearing on this stage.
Dick Gaudier, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Della Reese, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flay.
Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time for Match 76. Thank you. Goodbye. Let's go. We polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Everything blank. Now, the answer that group gave most frequently is worth $500, but you got to match it. If you match a middle one, you get $250. You match a bottom one, you get $100. Can't lose here, can you?
I got it.
Now, three of the ding-a-lings are permitted to help.
Trish.
How about Everything is Coming Up Roses?
Everything is Coming Up Roses. We don't want you to sing, Brett. When we want you to sing, we'll ask you, Brett, okay?
Okay, let me have it, Brett.
Everything goes.
That's it. That's your answer.
Everything goes, all right? You can call on one more.
Edward.
It's tough. I said for nothing.
No. What?
Wrong.
That's it.
Everything for nothing.
Where's my...
Everything.
Everything for nothing. That's his answer. I don't know what it means, but there it is. Everything for nothing. Everything goes, and everything's coming up roses. Now, do you want one of those? A better idea might have crossed your mind. Think.
Nothing has crossed my mind in years.
What did I say? What do you want? Everything for nothing. Everything goes.
Everything goes. That's it.
That it?
That's it.
Oh, you said that a little while ago. Yeah.
That's it.
That's it.
I made up my mind.
Okay, everything goes what he wants. That's the answer that Brett gave him. Here we go. We're going to find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Let's go down to the bottom. We will reveal the $100 response. Everything's coming up roses.
That's
Trish's answer. Yeah. Okay, we're looking for Everything Goes. Here's a $250 number.
Get ready to match the stars. Edward Asner, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Trish Stewart, Richard Dawson, and Patty Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rayburn.
Now, let's say hello to these gifted and celebrated people. You are all gifted and celebrated.
That's true.
And that's all I have to say.
Oh, okay.
But I greet you one and all and ask you to join me in greeting Jerry Gay and Lyle Bliss. Jerry Lyle and Gay Bliss. Gay Lyle and Bliss Jerry. Listen, this is Jerry Gay. She's our current champ. She's got a pretty good bundle of money, $5,600. That's very good of you. That's an interesting pendant you're wearing. I've never seen that exactly, but... it's. Can you see that?
I can.
You can? Well, it's an arrow pointing to the nether regions, and that's as far as we can explore that. Now, Lyle, you did very well.
Yeah, but I didn't win any money.
Everything is beautiful.
Everything I have is yours.
Everything but the kitchen sink, thank you.
It's anything goes.
Oh, you don't think it's going to come up? Anything goes.
If it does, it does.
And if it doesn't, it doesn't. You really are a true philosopher. You know that?
Everything goes on this one. Tense up.
Tense up, he says.
Got it. Guy in the second row, it's past tense up.
Past tense up. But, yes.
Could you ask Lyle to get back on his mark? We can't see.
No, there's the adhesive tape.
I never forget a back, but that's ridiculous.
One foot on the mark. All right, last chance here for everything goes. May we see the $500 number? Oh, he's got it! Congratulations.
You
got it.
I was waiting for everything to come up there.
Funny.
I'm so messed up. I'm so excited. You know, I need a funnel to stick my finger in my ear. I cleaned that up. You wouldn't believe it.
So listen, you picked up another $500 here. You got a total of $600, Lyle.
Clear thinking, no one.
But you can play for 10 times the $500 now.
Oh, shucks, you say.
No.
Big deal to say that.
No, you're going to play for $5,000 now.
$5,000.
Ding. That's it. Thank you. Okay, you're on your mark.
That's right.
Get set.
Now, wait. No, wait. I'll tell you.
I got to pick.
You got to pick one person.
They all look so nice. Set.
And he's cute and everything, and he's sexy.
I like him because he's versatile. You know, when he played in Rich Man, Poor Man, he did a very interesting thing there. Beautiful fight. Okay. Karen said, my husband is really mean. He took all my padded bras and left me...
flat.
Oh, she's too smart for this job.
She came up with the definitive answer. Now it's up to the celebrities.
How much more of the shame am I going to have to take?
Oh, what do you mean? Huh? You didn't do it again, huh?
I mean, the shame is almost as bad as your eulogy. I said the stuffing.
Uh-huh. Took all my padded bras and left me the stuffing. Now you got to match all of the others, Jerry, and let's see what Brett has.
Oh, Jerry, I'm so sorry. That's a terrific answer. I said his jockey shorts.
His jockey shorts, so that means Lyle Bliss wins the game. What the rest of you bet? Flat, 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 flat. All the others have flat. Come on down, Lyle. Remember how this goes? What's that?
She had the answer.
She had the answer, right. Well, listen, you can't win them all there. Don't turn your back to the audience. Right. They're out that way. You stand right here, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, Jerry Gay, you'll be leaving here with $5,600. And our best wishes. It was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you. I really enjoyed it.
I'm glad you did. Jerry
Bye-bye.
Gay. Goodbye. Okay. Stand on the adhesive tape. All right. You can look out that way now. Okay. They're out that way. That's okay.
I see them out there.
You see them out there? Oh, good. Now, listen, Lyle, you can win over $5,000 here. You ready for that?
I'm ready.
You didn't win any money yet?
Well, is when you make money.
Well, now, wait a minute. We went to the tiebreaker. You had your tiebreaker question. You matched 5 out of the 6 celebrities. So she's got a lot of hard work to do.
Five isn't enough. And it was interesting, though, you said Jerry Bliss. And that happens to be my brother's name.
No kidding.
Yeah, his hair's a little longer, and he's got bluer eyes, but he looks something like her.
We'll finish this tiebreaker right after we pass along these messages to you. Here we go. Tiebreaker. Now, Jerry Gabe, this is yours. Whoops, there it is. Remember what you have to do. You got match 5 to tie for the second tiebreaker or 6 to win. Everybody plays.
Sure.
Karen said, my husband is really mean. Rotten. You are a rotten bunch of performers. No. My husband is really mean. He took all my padded bras and left me blank. My husband is really mean. He took all my padded bras and left me blank. My husband is really mean. All righty.
Is Charles ready?
Charles is ready.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Very good.
Ready.
Okay, Edward is the slow one this trip. But remember, he's a big nighttime star on CBS's Mary Tyler Moore Show.
Terrific.
And he is terrific.